Five games down, five to go till the end of the regular season. Welcome to the pregame show. I'm Ted Madden. The halfway mark is a good time to take the bye week, and three of our teams are doing just that. West, Poteet, and North all do not have games this weekend. But West and North played each other last week for the first time ever. The Wranglers got on the board on a short touchdown run by DeJuan Limbrick, the first of two he had in this game. Now in the second quarter, West leading 7-3. Quarterback Craig Dale airs it out to his main target, Javion Jackson, who comes up with the catch deep in North Mesquite territory, and that set up Limbrick's second touchdown. That 10-point lead was erased in about 10 seconds. On the ensuing kickoff, Chase Adams took off. Adams would stay on that far sideline for an 80-yard kickoff return to make it 14-9. The Stallions came back in the second half with their backup quarterback, Jaquelon Caraway. He threw it up and let big play receiver Cordell Russell make a play. And that touchdown put the Stallions ahead 16-14. After West kicked a field goal to retake the lead, Caraway and Jalon Hicks hooked up on a 64-yard scoring strike, Caraway giving his receivers a chance to make big plays, and they came through for him. Later in the fourth, Russell made another huge play on a punt return for a touchdown, the Stallions' second special teams touchdown in the game. North Mesquite wins the first ever matchup against West Mesquite, 30-24, the final. 3 miles to the east, the Mesquite Skeeters had their homecoming game against Tyler Legacy. Sophomore Samaje Wallace got the start and took advantage of it. In the first quarter, he hooks up with Jamarion Woods on a fade route for the first score of the game. Now in the second, Wallace throws his second touchdown pass, this one to David Robinson, who makes a nice run after the catch for a 14-0 lead. Wallace's third touchdown pass was Woods' second TD catch, and Woods did most of the work here, weaving through the defense en route to a 49-yard score. The Skeeters led 23-7 at halftime. Tyler Legacy scored in the third quarter to cut the lead to 9, and then Wallace unleashed his fourth touchdown of the game, and this was huge. He hits Elijah Baeza in stride, and then Baeza strides the rest of the way for a 98-yard touchdown pass and catch. How about one more? Wallace threw his fifth touchdown pass to Jameer Dewberry, and the Skeeters are now 3-2 after beating Legacy 37-14. Next up for the Skeeters is Rockwall-Heath. This could be a significant game depending on who makes the playoffs. Heath and Mesquite could both make it in Division II, and the Skeeters would like to be ahead of the Hawks in that bracket.
They could be small school if the red school gets in, so it's a big, big game for us. I mean, they're well coached. They're going to play hard. Man, we're excited for the challenge and just want to get after those guys.
Mesquite Horn plays the preseason favorite to win district, the Rockwall Yellow Jackets. Both teams are 4-1 and 1-0 in the district, so this is a big one.
You rarely see these opportunities to play one of the state's best to see where you are. You know, but again, we can't really focus on who they are. We have to focus on who we are.
The Mesquite ISD inducted 10 new members into the Athletics Hall of Honor last Friday afternoon, and then honored those inductees on the field at Memorial Stadium before the game between North and West. The class of 2022, which is the fifth induction class into the Hall of Honor since it was founded in 2018, included one team, two coaches, two legacy members, and five athletes. Next time you're at Memorial Stadium, you can check out the Hall of Honor displays at both entrances on the home side of the stadium. You can also watch videos on every inductee right there at the stadium or online at the Mesquite Hall of Honor website. That's it for this week. Thank you for supporting Mesquite ISD Athletics, and enjoy your game.